Even the most clean, well-run governments have some level of corruption. And every government can function with a certain amount, right? But there's a tipping point. Somewhere on that scale, you get to a number where it doesn't work anymore,
yeah.
where everyone has to be bribed. The United States used to rank at a level much higher than we rank now. At what point do you get to a place where it doesn't matter what Dave Rubin wants or Dan Carlin wants, you don't get what you want. For example, all these politicians, you know where the real flaw in our system is a politician can promise anything they want. There's nothing that holds them to it. You have more protection in a handshake relationship with your gardener than you do with a person running for president, because they get into office and change their minds. The only reason you voted for them is what they told you they do.
Right.
What if they don't do it? Well, you could say, well, I won't vote for them in 4 years. Then in 4 years, you'll get to a place where it's them against another
idiot. Some other nut.
That's right, and you can't, and you hate them both.
Right.
And what are you gonna, but that's where the two parties kill us, because they put people, I mean, this, and this election is the best example you'll ever see. How many people held their nose, regardless of who they voted for, and voted for someone they didn't want because they really couldn't stand the other guy even more, or the other gal even more? Who said that they get to pick your choices? And they say, well, you had a whole primary process. Yes, but who got to be in the debates? And who decided that? A commission made up of half Democrats and half Republicans?
How is it that we let the Democrats and Republicans decide that the third party could only get in at 15% nationally? We let the other two parties
decide. Okay, but once
again,
we get back down to the level.
Yeah.
We let them.
Yeah.
We let them. And this is, you know, I said it, and people hate when I do this, about looking at the bright side of some of these things, but sometimes you don't get the right reforms in government until somebody crosses a line. Was Watergate a good thing for the country or a bad thing? Well, when President Gerald Ford pardoned Nixon, he said, our long national nightmare is over. But we got reforms mm-hmm. after that that are the best reforms we've had in 40 years. So was Watergate worth it? So you say to yourself, okay, if you have to fall off the ledge for us to fix something in this system, should we fall off the ledge? Okay, only if it gets fixed, right?
Right? Not if so it's a bottomless
pit. If you have a constitutional crisis, it's a great thing if afterwards you solve things. It's a bad thing if you lose.
Yeah.
And so that's the, with Donald Trump, I can sit there and go, God, you know, when they talk about a constitutional crisis, just hearing the word constitution sounds like a reform, right? We're talking about it, but what if you lose? So in that sense, I'm torn between, if you had elected Hillary Clinton, all those people that are upset with Donald Trump, you would have gotten more of the same, and I would suggest it's 50 to 60 years of slouching towards unconstitutionality. I mean, to me, Donald Trump looks like chemotherapy. He could kill us faster, or he could be something that prompts the equivalent of Democratic, and I don't mean Democratic Party, I mean Democratic antibodies.
Yeah.
He reminds us why authoritarianism is dangerous, and what could happen. There's a lot of people who don't think about politics at all. We have lives. We have things in our own life that we have to focus on. I mean, you want your country to run on autopilot, and you want it to run well mm-hmm. on autopilot. But in a system of representative democracy, if the people don't flex their muscles long enough, things get wiggy. It's been 40 or 50 years since we've gone out there with our feet and told government, no, you can't do this. And it takes, you know, they talk about a women's protest with millions of people, and that's great. But that doesn't work. It has to be protest.
Now,
yeah, you have to maintain
next.
It.
Yeah.
And then they listen. But you could lose. And if we lose, then you have to have a plan B country.